Now, we sketch the proof of the phase separation in the symmetric setting and how we use it to solve the symmetric optimal partition problem on the sphere.
Recall that physics was telling us how to obtain a phase separation. So what we do is the following. We look for a subsequence, or we look for a sequence in this space, the product of L times the subvolume space, and we consider for each k to be uk to be the solution of our system, which was given by this u2 star m minus 2 minus some beta ij ui alpha ij ui j beta ij minus 2, but we put here the coefficients, the competitive coefficients, depending on k. So in such a way that lambda ij k, this goes to minus infinity. So for each k, we have a system, and for each system, we obtain with our last theorem, we obtain a solution in such a way that this is the infimum of J in the whole space with symmetry. So this is, each of these solutions is a least energy solution that we have proved. So if we consider the solutions, we prove that this sequence is bounded. So UK will converge to something. I will call it U infinite weakly in this space, but we also have the compactness. So the compactness of the embedding, since the M2Rn with symmetries is compactly embedded in this space, we have that actually UK converge strongly to something. So we needed here the Palesme condition again and the compactness of the embedding. So the physics, our physics intuition said that this may have a phase separation. The support of each of the components of this function will separate, will be, the supports will be disjoint. How do we see that? So, how do we obtain that the supports are going to be disjoint? Here we use the coupling terms, and also we use that the competitive coefficients go to minus infinity, and we see that the supports are disjoint, where u equal u infinite is u1 infinite and ul infinite. How do we see this? We have here, using the coupled terms, that this is JK, I, this guy, and you, JIK, beta, IJ. This is given by the least energy solution. These guys are less or equal than C, a constant, over minus lambda IJ. Since lambda IJ is negative, minus lambda IJ is positive, and also there is a dependence on K. And since this guy goes to minus infinity, this guy goes to zero. But using Fatou lemma, we have that actually this product, infinite I this, u j infinite beta I j, this is less or equal than the limit of this guy. So we have actually that this integral is zero. So if this integral is zero, what we are saying is that if this integral is obtained by the product of these functions, and which are both positive, so we're concluding that u I times u j will equal zero almost everywhere in Rn. And from this, we conclude that the supports may be disjoint. So all the magic is given by these competitive terms. And also, here we are using strongly the weakly coupled terms in order to obtain this compact supports, this disjoint supports, excuse me. So what is going to be our optimal partition solution? We have here u I infinite on Rn to R, it is not obvious, as I said in the introduction, it is not obvious if the solution is positive or it changes sign. So when the solution is positive, one only has to take the closure of its support. But imagine that this function do this. So this is the graph of u. Imagine that these functions do this. If we take the closure of the support, let's make a better proof. Let's say that this is the function. So in order to obtain the domain, we are going to take this, which is the support, union some points. In this drawing are some points. In general, these are some zero Lebesgue measure sets. So instead of giving this, we take omega I equals to the interior of the support of UI. So we are having this open set. Here, how do we know that you change a sign in something which is, let's say, thin, which has Lebesgue measure zero? For instance, what happens if instead of having this row, we have something like this? So all this guy is zero, and we have this. Oh, sorry. This kind of behavior is not allowed because we have we give an argument using the using unique continuity theorem given by Lookhaus, and using this we were able to say that actually that we are not going to obtain this kind of singularities, but what we are going to obtain was our first row, like this. And so we prove that ui infinite u omega I from I equals 1 to L is a solution to the problem. Because we also prove, since the space of gamma invariant functions is weakly closed, this guy is gamma invariant. And since these domains are obtained using the support of a gamma invariant function, these are also gamma invariant. We also obtain a regularity result. We said that we obtain that u infinity I lies in C2m alpha omega I, and u this guy lies in Cm of Rn. So weak solutions are going to be strong solutions. How can we obtain this? This is really interesting because since we are dealing with this space and the problem on this space, as I said, this is equivalent to solve the problem on Sn via the stereographic projection. This is an isometry. Via stereographic projection. So we wanted to study this space. But in order to study this space, we saw that the quotient of Sn with gamma, this guy was 0 pi. So what we actually have is that if we consider a function lying on this space, we take u lying here, then using the quotient map, we reduce everything to a one-dimensional problem. So we are saying that we're studying actually a problem in y dimension. So what we obtained was the following, that there is an isometry of some Sobolev space with a weight on 0 pi. And since this is a one-dimensional manifold using our compactness results and everything else, we have that this space is compactly embedded, it is embedded in CM. And using again to see that U infinite I lies in this guy, we use an argument using unique continuity, unique continuation by lookout. So what we're saying here is that actually our problem is not n-dimensional, but it is one-dimensional. We can reduce a function with symmetries to a function on zero pi. So finally, I will state our main result. And our main result is as follows. The gamma invariant optimal partition problem L partition, this is the gamma invariant L optimal partition problem. We are looking for L solutions, L for L domains having some properties. The gamma invariant L optimal partition problem has a solution. And the solution was, is given by these guys that I have defined before, which is the interior of the support of each of these functions. And each one of these using the regularity argument lies on 2m alpha omega I. And also we were able to describe the geometry of these sets. These sets, well, they are gamma invariant, but we have more information using this quotient map, which is a isoparametric function. So what we obtain is the following. We were able to prove that in the space zero pi, all these domains are represented by a connected interval. So if we lift these intervals, each of these points here lift to an isoparametric hypersurface. I cannot draw the isoparametric surface, which is a product of spheres, but I will imagine that this is the product of spheres. This is to sum S n 1 minus 1, S n 2 minus 1. And everything that is lying in each of these intervals is lifted to the space between these intervals. And if we apply the stereographic projection, we're going to obtain the domains. Well, we're going to obtain that these hypersurfaces are mapped into this toroid. And the space between this toroid, all the space between this toroid is represented by the omega i's. So the omega i's is the space between some toroid in Rn. So if we do this, since we have here, if we do the stereographic projection from this point here, what we are going to obtain is that this domain will be unbounded. All other domains are diffeomorphic, and this is another kind of domain. We have some domains looking like this on the sphere, and some domains looking like this on the sphere, so their topology is different. But using this idea, we were able to prove that the geometry behind these sets is the following. We have that omega one, we were able to see that this is omega one, this is the projection of omega one, and this is the projection of omega L up to the stereographic projection. So we obtain that this is N minus one a sphere times, no, this is not, this is, yeah. This will represent omega I, this guy here. So this is Sn1 minus one times a ball. All the domains in the middle are products of spheres. Times an interval. And the unbounded domain is given explicitly by a ball in the first dimension times an Rn2 minus one. And also the geometry of the intersection of two consecutive of these domains is a product of spheres. So we were able to describe not only the solution, but also the geometry lying the geometry behind the solutions. For the research, in collaboration with Oscar Palmas and Jonathan Torres from UNAM, we are looking for the gamma invariant optimal partition problem on any closed manifold. So we are dealing with another kind of conformal operator, which is not as simple as the one given in the sphere. And this conformal operator of order M is more or less PG. It is the Laplacian, M times the Laplacian plus lower order terms. But these lower order terms are really complicated. So it is not obvious how to reduce this equation into an ODE, and it is not obvious how to see that the Sobolev space with symmetries is isometric to a weighted Sobolev space on an interval. Even if we are looking for gamma, for this gamma, is a closed subgroup of M G such that it has cohomogeneity one action. When we have a cohomogeneity one action, actually, this is saying that the orbits are given by an isoparametric function. So we were able to do this same approach using any isoparametric function given the foliation, given the foliation of the action given by gas. But as I told you before, this, even if we can reduce this operator to a one-dimensional operator, it is not obvious how to reduce this. So what we are studying is, first, we are studying the case M is Einstein. And in this case, we obtain the same result because we were able, when the operator is Einstein, it is as simple as the operator of the sphere. So the almost the same arguments hold for this kind of space. But we are also trying to handle when M is a Ricci soliton, which is a more general manifold than the Einstein manifold, but where the Ricci curvature is not really, is not that complicated. Finally, we have the open question. All the motivation was to try to give solutions to this problem, the Q curvature problem on Rn, in such a way that it has exactly L domains. So we were looking for solutions having a prescribed number of sign changes. This was our motivation, but our methods were not able to give a solution to this problem because we have a lack of the maximum principle, and because the solutions to the optimal partition problem, the functions satisfying this optimal partition problem, we were not able to see that these solutions are positive. If they were positive, maybe there is maybe we can define a solution. But actually, what we have is that one solution ui, maybe one solution ui changes many times the sign, so we cannot control the number of sign changes, and also we cannot prescribe the number of sign changes because each of these solutions have another prescribed number of sign changes. So this is the open question, and I invite you to attack this problem, which is really, really interesting. And so, thank you for your attention.